Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yank here. We're back for some more Let's Play Pokemon Crystal. In the last part, we finally received our 8th and final gym badge of Johto, and right now, we're about to enter Professor Elm's lab because he seemed to have something important for us waiting. And after we talk to him, we're going to make our way to the Pokemon League and take on the Elite Four Challenge to become the Pokemon Master of the Johto region, because looking at our player card right now, we have all 8 badges, and ignore the time. Oh my god, that's a big time number. But anyway, without further ado, let's go on inside and see what the professor has in store for us. Hi, Yankee. Thanks to you, my research is going great. Take this as a token of my appreciation. Yankee received the Master Ball? Okay. Wow, thanks a lot, Professor Elm. You're not so bad after all, and, okay, let's just talk about this for a second. Why does he have a Master Ball? Like, it's probably the most valuable substance in the Pokemon world. And two, why didn't Silver just steal this instead of the one of the Pokemon? I mean, something just doesn't add up here. Like, I'll just take the Master Ball and not ask any questions. How about that? The Master Ball is the best. It's the ultimate ball. It'll catch any Pokemon without fail. It's given only to recognized Pokemon researchers. I think you can make much better care of it. Use of it than I can, Yankee. Alright, thanks a lot, Professor. See ya! Okay, anyway. Yep, now that we've talked to him, let's actually stop by and say hi to Mom. Maybe she has something of value to talk to us about. Hi, welcome home. You're trying very hard, I see. I've got your room tidy. Or is this about the money? Oh, Mom, it's not about the money. I just wanted to see how you were. No, Mom, daylight savings is not over. Just do what you can. I'm sorry for visiting, Mom. You're obviously too busy watching the floor. But anyway, what we want to do right here is actually surf, and I got rid of Glove Crime because we needed an HM Slave, and Gary the Slave fits the bill because we need Waterfall, and he has Waterfall, and Whirlpool as well, as he showed off in the last part. And right now I gave him Surf. We'll get rid of, I don't know, Thrash. Really doesn't matter what moves I get rid of anyway, because we're never going to use him in battle. And just give him Surf, and now we are on our way to the Pokemon League. And let's equip a Repel right here, because I don't want to be running into any wild Pokemon, because the Pokemon we'll be running into are of no worth and no significance, so might as well just move on with our adventure, and let's step on land. Are we going to fight this guy? Hey, do you know what you just did? You've taken your first step into Kanto. Check your Pokegear map and see. Alright, I will, Mr. Man, and yeah, there we go. We are in the Kanto region, basically. Nico Plateau's all the way up there. We only have this limited amount of range in our viewing map, but if you look to the right, that map looks kind of familiar. It is of Kanto, the original region of Pokemon. So I can't wait until we get there, but for now, we gotta focus and keep our eyes on the prize and make our way to the Indigo Plateau. And let's see right here. I think if we surf down here, we can actually reach a rare candy. If memory serves me correctly, there's some other goodies, I believe, maybe some, like, trees with berries and whatnot, so let's see what we got here. Nope, just the rare candy, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, the rare candy, awesome. I think I have about 4 or 5 of them still stored. I'm probably going to be using them, obviously, before we take on the Elite Four Challenge. And I actually did some grinding off the screen, because on the way back down, obviously, I missed a bunch of trainers, so I went back and fought them, and, yeah, Golbat really got a buff right now. I made him go all the way to 28. I kind of neglected Umbreon because I'm really just trying to evolve Golbat as quickly as possible, because it would be nice to have a Crobat out and it would actually hold its own, not have to switch it out every now and then. But yeah, we'll just work on Umbreon for now. Tojo Falls, the link between Kanto and Johto. So this is what I was talking about. Basically, we needed a Pokemon with Waterfall. And I wouldn't give it to one of my main Pokemon because Surf is a better move and kind of be a waste to have Waterfall and Surf on Glovecrime. Because Glovecrime already has like a very limited amount of moves I want to get rid of anyway, because I still need to put on Dynamic Punch. I don't know what to get rid of. Because Body Slam's great, Hypnosis is great, and that trainer is not great, but we'll fight her, I guess. It's rare to see anyone come here. Are you training on your own? Yeah, all these people talk about like how hard it is to get to the Elite Four. There's never been a challenger, like really? I think they've been holding tournaments, like in the anime, they hold tournaments for that thing. There's a bunch of trainers, not hundreds, but like, handful of trainers, I mean, at least some, but in this one, it's like, oh, you reached the Elite Four, what the hell, that doesn't happen. But anyway, aw, she has a Bulbasaur, aw. That's a nice little introduction to the Kanto region, right? The first Pokemon we fight's a Bulbasaur. Brings back memories, and unfortunately, with Bulbasaur, it knows Poison Powder, Sleep Powder, and stuns Boar, but we'll get past that. Let's actually try a Shadow Ball and see if that does more damage, because Shadow Ball is actually a physical move in this game. I don't think I explained that. Unlike in later generations, it comes as special, so I think that works to our advantage with Umbreon, and luckily it didn't critical hit, and let's just take it out with Shadow Ball, and then I'll heal up Umbreon. So I believe she has the evolutions of the Bulbasaur family, yep, Ivysaur. So we'll leave out Umbreon, switch it out, it'll level up, and let's see who we want to put up against her. Unfortunately for her, my team specialized against grass, so let's put in Rocko and take her out. And Razor Leaf's not really going to do anything right here. So yeah, we're pretty much going to get to see all, like, the different new sprites of, like, Pokemon past, like, the Kanto region. I just love how, like, Ivysaur, I guess we haven't seen it yet, obviously, since it's a starter Pokemon. I just love how the sprites look for it. It just looks very clean. I just love the color, like, added to it. Like, coming from, like, playing Pokemon Red and Blue and then coming to this game, it's really cool to see, like, the changes, like, not only graphically, but the changes to the art style as well. And, ooh, Venusaur, okay, I might be gonna mess around with this thing, it might actually beat me. So, yeah, how'd she, that means she had three individual Bulbasaurs. Like, did she just jack Professor Oak, or she, like, make her Bulbasaur mate, like, constantly? Like, oh, man, can't even imagine. Well, let's see if that takes it out in one shot. Yes, it does, critical hit, nice. Yeah, I don't even think we would have been able to take it out in one shot if it wasn't a critical hit, so that was very lucky that we got that. That's like Arcanine attacks that. Wow, I just love that. You're really strong, yes I am. Alright, so let's go to this house right here. Ooh, we gotta heal up Umbreon. We're also hate us and de-evolve. Alright, let's give it the full heal. Nice. And let's talk to this lady right here because she'll have something to give us, hopefully. Where are you off to with Pokemon? Pokemon League? Are your Pokemon loyal enough for you to win? Let me see. Ah, your Pokemon trust you very much. It's nice to see a good trainer. Here, a gift for your journey. So yeah, you would think she would give us, like, return or something that has to do with friendship, but nope. It's just Sandstorm. It's a move that inflicts damage on both battlers. It's for advanced trainers only. Use it if you dare. Good luck. I could give that to Gara, but basically what it does, it's kind of like a Sunny Day in Rain Dance, but it actually inflicts damage. I think, don't quote me on this, I might be wrong, but I think it ups ground attacks, and it attacks each player per turn, but if the player is the type of ground, it doesn't affect them. But I'm kind of out of spectacle on the whole, like, it ups your ground attack moves. I don't know, I just know that every turn it inflicts a couple damage, so it's not really that good. But anyway, let's actually keep out Umbreon, but let's actually heal it up, and let's give it one of those, rare candy bars I bought, rage candy bars. Yeah, rare candy bars, that makes your Pokemon level up by 2, that would be amazing. Let's see here, we have to battle this guy, so let's do it. You look pretty strong, let me battle you. Alright, I mean, everyone's assuming I'm strong because, according to them, no one's ever taken on the Pokemon League in their life. So let's see, Blake, who do you have? A Magneton, Yeah, I've always, like, lamented that I didn't get electric Pokemon, but, hey, oh well. And what's actually funny is, okay, I can't really do anything against you. Time to bring out a fire type, or a ground. You know, I'll bring out a ground type. But I was, while I was making my way back down from Blackthorn City, I actually ran into a Skarmory and caught it. So, yeah, that's actually pretty cool. It was actually one of the Pokemon I was considering using on my team because Skarmory, it's a flying steel type, which is a pretty cool type in itself, and it's a very cool looking Pokemon. And I was gonna use it, but I was like, I'm more of an attack kind of guy, like attack and speed, those are my two favorite things. And Skarmory, it's a tank, but I don't know, I just thought getting a Crobat would be a little cooler, a little more fun. And let's see, this is my one weakness right here. I don't have anything that's strong against water. So I really should have gotten at least a grass Pokemon or an electric Pokemon, but alas, we don't have either or. So I'll have to make do, but yeah, in the end I decided with the Crobat because it looked, I don't know, I just like Crobats better, it's more of a preference thing. And let's just do return on this. Don't know if it's going to do a heck of a lot of damage. And what's actually funnily enough is, when you guys see the nickname I gave my, Skarmory, I think you'll like it. I wouldn't be shocked if you guessed it. Well, that's a little hint right there. Anyone who guesses that, really, really good on you. And, ooh, Earthquake, is that bad? Nope, it's just neutral, but still, that's gonna do a lot. And, Yeah, we're not going to have fun against this guy, I can already tell. Let's just go with our main and put in an Axel. I know he has Earthquake and Water moves, but... yeah, he's a freaking, like, both of his types, Water and Ground, are super effective against Axel, so I'm really just taking a chance right here, but it is one of my stronger Pokemon. And that's just the downside of having Fire Pokemon. Critical hit. Axel is just not having fun these last couple of parts. Well, let's go with Gara. I know he can use water moves, but we'll have to take that chance. And let's see. Let's go with the strength. A test of strength. Yeah, you throw that boulder at him. I like to imagine, like, sometimes if I use strength against, like, a Rattata or, like, a Hoppip or something, like, really small, like a Togepi, the rock would just smash the Pokemon to death. That's just such a gruesome thought to think about, because they're throwing this huge rock at the Pokemon, and, like, a little Pokemon like Togepi, not only would it die, it would die for real, huh? But, what else does he have? Execute, okay. So, yeah, you'll notice on the way to, the Elite Four, to Victory Road, I guess you would say, we'll be running into a lot of cool trainers. Cool trainers, if I haven't already mentioned, specialize in a variety of Pokemon since they're actually Pokemon trainers. They don't have like five of the same Pokemon. They don't have just one specific type. They actually mix it around. So this guy had a grass, ground, water, and his first one was what? I don't even know. That's Magneton. Okay. So yeah, a lot of variety. And Rocko, you're always so reliable. And cool trainer Blake is defeated. Yow. Yowza. So let's actually heal up Axel with a revive. We only have two, but we'll be running into someone later on that can actually heal up all our Pokemon, so yeah, just want to do it now because we have a couple more trainers coming up. Let's do Super Potions on Marowak, Umbreon, and Typlosion, and we should be set. So yeah, I benched Glovecrime, obviously, because it's level 40, and it had a lot of airtime, I guess you would say, in the last two parts, so decided to give it a nice long rest, and I actually realized afterwards as, wait, what? I'm running into higher level Pokemon, maybe? Doduo! See, that's why the trade was stupid back there for that Dragonair, because you can just get one right here. But like I was saying, the reason, what I learned in the last, part, just before I was recording, was I should have put on Never Melt Ice on Poliwrath. That was a very bad, bad thing I did, and I didn't put it on, and it would probably made the gym fight much easier, but hey, Poliwrath carried his own, didn't even need the, held item. And let's see what we want to do here. We also, well, let's just leave Umbreon again, but no, we can pass you, but not to you. Ha, a lot of Pokemon battles, that's for sure. Don't say a thing. Let me guess what you're thinking. I got it. You're on the Pokemon League Challenge. No, dude, I was just strolling around. I thought it was a nice day, and okay, you got me. I just love how everyone assumes everyone's on the way to the Pokemon League, because I guess why else would we be here? And hey, Starmie, nice, okay. I just love this little animation it does in this one. It just looks very nice. Let's go with Shadow Ball. I think it's super effective, isn't it? And Rapid Spin, one of the weakest moves in the game. Okay, thank you. Super effective. Yup, nice, because it's part Psychic in this. I think the original was just pure water. And are we going to have this battle? Are we going down this road? I forgot his name, but Psychic Trainer, are we really going to go down this road? I use Shadow Ball, you use Recover, everyone laughs, everyone cries, and you are. But luckily, I got Special Defense down, Special Defense down. So, is it a Special or is it a Physical in this game? I keep forgetting. I think it is Special. I always get confused, but why would it lower Special if it's a Physical move? So, that made me think that it's a Special now. I'm sorry about that. I get confused. I know in like one generation earlier it was a Special and then later it was a Physical, so I guess I got kind of confused there. So I'm sorry about that. I could have sworn it was a Physical move in the earlier generations, but oh well. So yeah, luckily this guy's a Psychic type trainer, so Umbreon is gonna get a lot of experience. And there we go, one more shot and he'll die. And Stun Spore, really? That's a mild inconvenience, but let's just go with it. And Leaf, I would say Parafusion, but it's Parasegion? Parasuction? There we go, that's a good one. And there we go, Execute is done. And your final Psychic Pokemon, what is it, Kadabra? Nope, Jiffrafrig. It's Girafarig spelled backwards, the same forward as it is backwards. Yeah, Jeffrey from Toys R Us. Let's actually go with Golbat. Taking kind of a gamble here, but bear with me. Golba has Bite, super effective against Psychic, but he has Psychic Move, maybe, so that's going to be super effective against our Poison type, but hey, we'll see what happens, and not a lot of damage. This is what I was worried about. Super effective fight! And okay, I didn't expect it to kill it, but I can't risk Golbat dying. I need its happiness still. So let's switch out to... Let's go to Marowak, why not? I just love the design. I don't think I mentioned of Jerifarig. It's hard to pronounce his name. It's just a weird name, but I guess they were going for, like I said before, the same backwards as it is forwards. And speaking of, do you guys know that the date this week is the same backwards as it is forward? I always thought that was pretty funny. When I looked at that like little fact this week, I was like, oh shit, I guess it is. And another thing about this guy, his tail kind of looks like a chain chomp in the back. I don't know, this Pokemon is very, very interesting design, I'll give it that. Alright, so let's just throw our Bone Club at it. And there we go. So yeah, we beat this guy and we got some experience. I'm really kind of curious how long this part's actually going to go, because my idea was to at least maybe get to the Inferno Victory Road, and oh, really? You're good, aren't you? I like to imagine, but I guess we're going to have a two-parter here and have a lot of just battles. Okay, this guy's one Pokemon. That's not anything to complain about. It's Sandslash. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, what's up, Sandslash? I love that it's like crossing its arms like, yo, what's up? You know what's up? Let's see, what are we gonna do here? Yeah, we don't have our water Pokemon with us, so we'll have to, have a little avenging of the death before by Axel, and we'll make him rise like a phoenix and take on the Sandslash head-on against another ground-type. I did that on purpose, just to prove that he can take down a ground-type, even though it's super effective against him. Fire Punch! Come on, take it out in one shot! Ooh, close, close Typhlosion, you almost got there. Alright, so let's see here. Let's just finish up with a Swift. And we'll swiftly win this fight. that was bad. So let's get more experience. And cool, Trainer Brian is defeated. So yeah, obviously I recommend taking out all these trainers, not only for the experience, but for the cash money, yo! Alan Schoolboy, you're the only one who calls me. The water guy never does. Do you have another stone for me, maybe? Potential is getting stronger, exactly as I calculated. By the way, Wild Pidgey escaped me on the other day. Computational error on my part, eh? Really should just delete him. He keeps on giving me Firestones. That's why I got his number in the first place to evolve Growlithe. And let's pass you because I know you have a Starmie. Haven't already fought a Starmie. Ooh, what the? Whirlpool. I have a Pokemon Whirlpool. I'll definitely do that. I don't remember this. Let's see. We need a Repel. There we go. Gonna definitely be needing to buy more Repels as we go on. And that's what happens if you can't do that. And speaking of Whirlpools, we'll be having to make our way back to, Olivine City, between that and the city that had the fighting guy, so... Oh, what the hell? There's a guy up here. I wonder what he's actually got to say, because he's like here in seclusion, and like, oh, okay, we got TM. It's actually pretty good. Let's see here... TM 22 is... Solar Beam! Wow, okay! Can anyone learn that on my team? I doubt it's a freaking grass move. Nope. But wow, okay, that was definitely worth getting, but I'm actually curious who this guy is and why he's over here. It's kind of like that trainer that's underneath the bike path, you wouldn't even, like, point him out. Okay, I really wish I ignored this guy. This guy is way into Twitter, but anyway, we'll take on this flying-type trainer, Jose. Farfetch'd, hey, it's a throwback to my first Let's Play, I had a Farfetch'd. Yeah, actually was the guy that used the freaking traded Farfetch'd in that. I was that guy, and, alright, return. Let's see what my return on investment is in with this, Tweet. Okay, I guess he was sending a tweet. Let's just swim back here and, get out of this, and we have to use Whirlpool again, okay. I guess imagine our Pokemon just like was like, oh, I don't, what's Whirlpool? I just forgot. We're stuck in here, game over. Now we have a flying Pokemon on our team. No, we don't, actually. That would have been chaotic, and let's just stay in the water right here. Route 26, and let's just see if there's anything to the left, and we will call it a part. And anything down here? Nope, just a little down area. Actually, we can go up there. Probably the next part that'll show what's up there. So yeah, basically, we fought a bunch of trainers in this part on our way to the Pokemon League Challenge, so in the next part, we'll be fighting another bunch of trainers and hopefully making our way to the entrance of Victory Road and maybe even taking out some of the trainers inside of it as well. So I'll see you later, guys, and until next time on Let's Play Pokemon Crystal.